जय श्री श्री गुरु गौरांग गंधार्विक गिरिधारी श्री श्री राधा विनोर विहारी जोखी जय श्री गोविंद गोपीनाथ मरण मोहन जोखी जय नित्यालय विष्णु विष्णुपार शुत रशत शिमार भक्ति वेदांत नारायण गोसाई महाराज श्रील गुरुदेव की जय नित्यालय विष्णु विष्णुपार शुत रशत शिमार भक्ति वेदांत वामन गोसाई महाराज की जय नित्यालय विष्णु विष्णुपार शुत रशत शिमार भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपार की जय नित्यालय विष्णु विष्णुपार शुत रशत शिमार भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोसाई महाराज की जय नित्यालय विष्णु विष्णुपार शुत रशत शिमार भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोसाई प्रभुपार की जय नित्यालय विष्णु महाभगवत श्रील गौर किशोरदास बाबूजी महाराज की जय नित्यालय विश्व श्रील सच्चिदानंद भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर की जय नित्यालय विश्व वैष्णव सार्वभौम श्री जगन्नाथ दास बाबूजी महाराज की जय श्री रूपानु गौरिया गुरु वर्ग की जय श्री रू श्रील बलदेव विभूषण प्रभु की जय श्री विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर की जय श्री नरोत्तम श्रीनिवास श्यामानंद प्रभु त्रय की जय श्री कृष्णदास कविराज गोस्वामी पार की जय श्री रूप सनातन भट्ट रघुनाथ श्री जीव गोपाल भट्ट दास रघुनाथ शारद गोस्वामी प्रभु की जय श्री स्वरूप दामोदर राय रामानंदारी श्री गौर पार्षद वृंद की जय नामाचार्य श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासरी गौर भक्त वृंद की जय श्री क्षेत्र मंडल गौर मंडल व्रज मंडल मथुर वृंदावन धाम की जय सर्व अभिष्ट प्रदाता गिरिराज महाराज की जय श्री राधा कुंड श्याम कुंड की जय श्री यमुना देवी गंगा देवी की जय श्री तुलसी महारानी वृंद देवी की जय श्री भक्ति देवी की जय श्री पूर्णमासी योगा माया की जय श्री गोपेश्वर महादेव की जय श्री श्रीमान नित्यानंद प्रभु अवधूत की जय पतित पावन श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय जय श्री नित्यानंद त्रयोदशी की जय जय श्री नित्यानंद त्रयोदशी की जय जय श्री हराय पंडित की जय श्री परमावती देवी की जय जय श्री वसुधा जानव की जय जय श्री वीरचंद्र प्रभु की जय द्वादश गोपाल की जय श्री श्री एक चक्र ग्राम की जय जय सपार्षद श्री गौर नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय श्री हरि नाम संकीर्तन की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय समागत गौर भक्त वृंद की जय श्री निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बो जय श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय हरे हरे कृष्ण एवरीबडी धन्यवाद प्रणाम्स हाय सो आई सॉरी आई एम अ बिट ऑफ अ मेस राइट नाउ I think maybe we should just so that I can clear my brain and get in the right mood. Maybe we can start with some kirtan. Sorry, I didn't sleep much last night, and there's just been a lot of on my mind, and so I think that would be good if we just, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna open up the songbook and. Yeah, I'm really depending on Nityananda Prabhu for this program to for him to control it because I'm not in a very good mental state right now. So, all right. So sharing my screen and then maybe we'll just sing one Gurudev Kirtan and then we can sing Nityananda song. Oh. What is it? Kave Tava Karuna Prakasha. Let's sing that one. Okay. O Gurudev, when by the manifestation of your mercy, with a deep conviction that Sri Gauranga's Leelas are eternal truth, will I chant the name of Hari and wander throughout the forests of Godrum with the aspiration to witness those Leelas? Nitai, Gauranga, Advaita, Srivas, and Gadadhar, these five personalities will flood the entire universe with the nectar of Sri Krishna's name by performing Maha Sankirtan. I shall hear the pastimes of dancing and of mridangas playing with my own ears. Constantly beholding the sweetness of these pastimes, I will float in the flood of prem. Upon losing my vision of these jewel-like pastimes, I shall cry out, Ha Gauranga! The materialists will proclaim me to be a madman and throw dust on my body. One second, I'm just going to fix the sound. Okay. All right, there. Oh, thank you, Brinda Didi. I can manage it. Thank you so much. O Gurudev, Karuna Prakashe Gurudev, Karuna Prakashe Shri Gauranga Lila Hoi Nita Tatva E Sudrida Vishvase Hari Hari Boli Kodroma Kanane Brahmi Badarshana Ashe Gurudev Kabe Tava Karuna Prakashe Nitai Gauranga Advaita Srivas Kadadara Panchajana Krishna nama rase bhasabe jagat kori mahasankirtan kori mahasankirtan nartana vilas mridanga vadan Shuni boyapana kane dekhiya shelila madhuri dekhiya shelila madhuri bhasibo premer bane Bhasibo premera vane dekhiya shelila madhuri bhasibo premera vane bhasibo premera vane Na dekhiya par shelila ratan kandiha gauranga boli amare vishai pagal bolia amare vishai pagal bolia angete dibe kadhuli angete dibe kadhuli Gurudeva kabe tava karuna prakashe Gurudeva kabe tava karuna prakashe Shri Gauranga Lila hoy nita tatva esu drida vishvase Hari Hari boli kodru makanane brahmi bodarshana ashe brahmi bodarshana ashe Jaya Guru Deva Guru Deva Guru Deva Jaya Guru Deva Jai Gurudeva, 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 Jai Gurudeva. Alright, so maybe we can sing a Nityananda kirtana and then we'll start. My throat's not so good right now, sorry. Nitai Parakamala. And then at the end, I thought we could end off with singing maybe the Nityānandāṣṭakam and the Nityānanda, the Āvirbhāva-līlā kirtan for Nityānanda. Okay. The lotus feet of Nitai are as cooling as millions of moons. Their shade gives solace to the entire universe. Without a personality such as Nitai, O brother, it is not possible to attain Radha and Krishna. So firmly take hold of his lotus feet. If someone does not establish a relationship with Nityānanda Prabhu, his human birth is wasted. Such an animalistic person is very wicked. Not uttering the name of Nitai with his lips, he drowns himself in the so-called happiness of the material world. What then can his education and pedigree do for him? Maddened by false pride and forgetting Nitai's lotus feet, one considers illusion to be truth. If Nitai is merciful, one can attain Radha and Krishna and Raj. Should it be if Nitai? It should just be by Nityananda, when Nityananda is merciful. Okay, one can attain Radha and Krishna and Raj. So firmly take hold of Nitai's two lotus feet. The lotus feet of Nitai are eternal truth, and his servitors are eternally liberated. Always aspire to attain the lotus feet of Nitai. Narottam is very unhappy. O Nitai, please make me happy by keeping me close to the reddish souls of your lotus feet. Nitai pada kamala koti chandra shushitala Aje chaya jagat jo rai He no nitai bine bhai Radha Krishna paite nai Drida kori Dharo Nitai Pai Drida Kori ধরণী তার পা সম্বন্ধ নাহি যায় ও বৃথা জন্ম গেল তার আসে পশু বড় দুরাচার নিতাই না বলিল মুখে ও মজিল সংসার সুখে বিদ্যা কুলে কি করিবে অহংকারে মত হইয়া নিতাই পদ পাশরিয়া আস্যতে রে সত্য করি মানে নিতাই করুণা হবে ব্রজে রাধা কৃষ্ণ পাবে অনিতায়ের করুণা হবে ও ব্রজে রাধা কৃষ্ণ পাবে ধরণী তায়ের চরণ দুখানি ধরণী তায়ের চরণ দুখানি নিতায়ের চরণ সত্য তাহার সেবক নিত্য নিতাই পদ সদা কর আশ নিতাই পর সদা কর আশ নরোত্তম বড় দুঃখী অনিতাই মোরে করো সুখী নরোত্তম বড় দুঃখী নিতাই মোরে করো সুখী রাখ রঙ চরণের পাশ রাখ রঙ চরণের পাশ নিতাই পর কমল কোটি চন্দ্র সুশীতল নিতাই পর কমল কোটি চন্দ্র সুশীতল যে ছায়ায় জগত জুড়ায় যে ছায়ায় জগত জুড়ায় হেন নিতাই বিনে ভাই রাধা কৃষ্ণ পাইতে নাই হেন নিতাই বিনে ভাই রাধা কৃষ্ণ পাইতে নাই দৃঢ় করি ধরো নিতার পায় দৃঢ় করি ধরো নিতার পায় জয় নিত্যানন্দ রাম নিত্যানন্দ রাম নিত্যানন্দ রাম জয় নিত্যানন্দ রাম জয় নিত্যানন্দ রাম নিত্যানন্দ রাম নিত্যানন্দ রাম জয় নিত্যানন্দ রাম
Actually, could we do one last one? I'll just, yeah, and then we'll start. What time is it? 7:23. Yeah, I think we can fit in one last one. Okay. Haha kobe goranitai. God. Sorry, I'm really sorry about my throat. Okay. Alas, alas. When will the two brothers, Gaur Nitai, bestow their abundant mercy upon this most fallen person and show themselves to him? By the power of their mercy, I shall see the transcendental splendor of Raj in Navadvip. I shall behold the enchanting Ananda Sukara Kunj with greedy eyes. Near to Ananda Sukara Kunj is Sri Lalita Kund, surrounded by hundreds and hundreds of bejeweled sitting places where Shishi Radha Krishna expands the incessant revelry of their pastimes. All of their sakis are there to assist in these pastimes, realizing the joy of rendering various kinds of seva. This maidservant is also present, running here and there to carry out the duties on the order of her saki. Stringing a garland of malati flowers, I shall bring it and place it in the hands of my saki. She will place it around the necks of Shishi Radha Krishna, and I shall dance, filled with ecstasy. It's only by the mercy of Gaur Nitai that this will ever be possible, this kind of destination. As we read in the previous song, Nitayar Karuna Habe, Vraje Radha Krishna Pabe, Heno Nitai Bine Bai, Radha Krishna Paite Nai. There's no way to attain Radha Krishna in Vraj without the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. Because Nityananda Prabhu, he is Sandhini Shakti. He's the platform. He's like the existence potency. He's the Adar Shakti. Samvit and Ladini it needs something to hold it. It can't just come into Nityananda Prabhu. He manifests as the Dham. He manifests he is the soul, like he is the sole authority when it comes to service for Krishna in any form. And he's serving in every way, in every form. And he is the platform. Mahavishnu rests on Nityananda Prabhu. He manifests as a Dham. Krishna performs his pastimes in Vraj Dham, which is a manifestation of Nityananda Prabhu. Everything. And so our heart needs also Nityananda Prabhu to manifest there so that Radha and Krishna can perform their pastimes. Yeah, sorry, I'm not explaining clearly. But anyways, we'll read from our acharyas. Okay.
Aha kabe Gaura Nitai, oh ha kabe Gaura Nitai, e patita jane uru kripa kori. E patita jane uru kripa kori dekha dibe duti bhai dekha dibe duti bhai oh ha kabe Gaura Nitai Duhu Kripa Bole Navadvipa Dhame Dekhibo Vrajer Shobha Ananda Sukhada Kunja Manohara Heribo Nayana Loba Taharani Kate Shilalita Kunda Ratna Bedi Koto Shata Jatharadha Krishna Lila Vistariya Bihare Nabirata Sakhi gana jatha lila rasa hai nana seva sukha pai edasita thai sakira yagyate karje iti uti dhai mala tira mala gati ayani bo devota be sakhi kare radha krishna kole sakhi porai be radha krishna kole sakhi porai be nachibo ananda bore nachibo ananda bore ha ha kabe gora nita oh ha ha kabe gora nita patita jane uru kripa kori e patita jane uru kripa kori dekhadibe duti bhai o dekhadibe duti bhai jaya goranitai jaya goranitai Goranitai jaya goranitai jaya goranitai 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 jaya goranitai jaya navadvip dham jaya vrindavan dham navadvip dham jaya vrindavan dham jaya navadvip dham jaya vrindavan dham navadvip dham jaya vrindavan Jaya Radhe Jaya Krishna Jaya Radhe Jaya Krishna Oh Jaya Radhe Jaya Krishna Jaya Radhe Jaya Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Nitai Gaur Hari Bol Nitai Gaur Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol
All right. So.
Hare Krishna everybody. Dandavat pranams. Nri Hari Prabhu, Bhavatarini Mataji, Jayashri Didi, Subhadra Didi, Shubhananda Prabhu, Champak Mataji. And let's see on YouTube and Facebook, let's see who's there. Vrinda Didi, Hare Krishna, Ganga Mataji, Raseshri Mataji, Vidyalalasa Didi, Rajbhuvan Yadavji, Rukmini Didi, and a bunch of other devotees. Wow, I see there's 12 people there on YouTube and Facebook. Pranams, everybody. Usually I plan out our readings a little bit better, but I've just been too flat out. I haven't really. So what I'm planning to read is this book. Where is it? This book, A Treasure of Holy Days by my Śrīla Gurudeva. We're going to read the chapter on Nityānanda Trayodaśī. And then last year I put out a post on Vine of Devotion with some beautiful excerpts from one from Śrīla Bhaktivedānta Śrīdhara Gosvāmī Mahārāja's class, and one from the book Sri Guru and His Grace about the mercy of Nityānanda Prabhu. And it's one of the most
hope-inspiring, beautiful things I've ever read. It's really, yeah, it's really special. So we'll end off with that. And yeah, that will be our program for today. So let me just find this. Okay. Just opening up the ebook. Where is it? Oh yeah, it should be here. Prabandavali. Yeah, the book used to be called Prabandavali and now it's called A Treasury of Holy Days. Nityānanda Trayodaśī. So this is chapter 8. And these are all classes that Śrīla Gurudeva gave, I think, in 1991, if I remember correctly, in Keshavji Gaudiya Math. Actually, let's see if I can make it so I can scroll. That would be better. I thought I could do that. Anyways, doesn't matter. Controls. Nope. Maybe I'll just minimize this then. Okay. Sorry, this text is too big. Let me make it smaller. What the heck? You guys are going to have to be a little bit patient with me today because my brain isn't really functioning very well. This morning after Mangal Aarti, I had to have, like while I was in the middle of leading, I had to have somebody take over because my mind is just like a bit messed up right now. Okay, so chapter 8, Nityānanda Trayodaśī. Once there was a barber who was going here and there giving out invitations. In previous times, barbers performed this task for families. If there was to be a marriage or a festival, he would go and distribute the invitations to everyone. And for doing this, he would earn a little extra money. But he would not go anywhere without his instruments, such as a razor, scissors, and a comb. Starting on his way, this barber entered a jungle where he saw a lion resting on the path. The lion did not attack him, but instead was merely lifting up its paw and licking it. At first, the barber was frightened. But then he thought, it seems that there is something stuck in his foot, and that is why he is not attacking. So the barber went a little nearer and saw that a very large thorn was stuck in very deeply. And due to this, the lion was suffering greatly. Therefore, with the help of his instruments, the barber manipulated the thorn a little and carefully removed it. Some blood had been coming from the wound, so he applied some antiseptic, wrapped the lion's paw in some medicinal leaves, and then left. Very brave barber. 3 or 4 years went by. Then, one day, that same barber was mistakenly arrested for some very serious crime, such as murder. His case was brought before the king, who said, "Several days ago in the jungle, we captured a lion. Throw the criminal into the lion's compartment. The lion will eat him. Finished. For him, there can be no other punishment. Throw him in." The barber was thrown into the lion's cage, and at once the lion got up, roaring. But as he came near the barber, he began to purr and sat down. This was the same lion from which the barber had removed the thorn, and after so many years, the lion recognized the barber and therefore did not attack him. The king said, "This fierce animal is not attacking him? What is this?" Then he thought, "Now I understand. Because I have made a mistake in arresting this man, the lion is not killing him. If the lion is not carrying out this punishment, then I also should not punish him." The king released the barber, showed him respect, and asked for forgiveness. Even in an animal, there is so much gratitude. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says that Nityananda Prabhu's gratitude is just like this. For 1 minute, that barber removed a thorn from the lion, and for so many years, the lion remained grateful. That animal, which is so fierce that it kills innumerable other animals and people also, remains grateful for its entire life. And we see the same quality of gratitude in the life of Nityānanda Prabhu. In Śrī Caitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami gives an example of how Nityānanda Prabhu, being Bhagavan himself, is merciful to someone. He says that on one occasion, there was to be a festival with kirtan going on continuously, all day and night. Vaishnavs who lived both nearby and far away, Vaishnavs who lived both nearby and far away were invited, and they all came. Amongst them was an eternal associate of Nityānanda Prabhu named Miniketan Ramdas. His nature was such that his mercy could not be easily recognized, but those who understood him could see it. Yeah, he had a very interesting way of showing his mercy. Generally, if some dear person comes, one offers pranam. But instead, he would hit somebody with a flute, which he always kept in his hand, and that person would understand it to be great mercy. When he would place his foot on the head of someone, they would consider that there would be good fortune in their lives from that day on. Sometimes, he would slap someone and say, "Where have you been all these days?" But those who understood knew that whoever was struck today will receive the direct mercy of Nityānanda Prabhu. So kirtan was going on, and when I don't know why I'm having a hard time saying his name. When Miniketan Ramdas came, everyone stood up, offered pranam to him, and welcomed him. He climbed on the shoulders of one person, hit another with his flute, and slapped another on the back. Tears were always flowing from his eyes, and he was always roaring out, "Nityānanda Prabhu ki jai!" The pujari there was somewhat educated, and when Miniketan Ramdas entered, while everyone else had stood and offered pranam, this pujari didn't. He didn't stand. And he also wouldn't speak to him. So, laughing, Miniketan Ramdas said, "Here we find the second Romaharshan." And Romaharshan is a personality who offended Baladeva Prabhu at a fire sacrifice being performed at Naimisharanya, as described in chapter 78 in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Everybody stood up in the assembly when Baladeva Prabhu came, except for Romaharshan Sutta, and that was so in the same way. Everybody stood up, except for the pujari. Everyone performed very loud kirtan, and when it was finished, Kaviraj Goswami's brother said, "You're always singing about the glories of Nityānanda Prabhu, but why don't you sing the glories of Chaitanya Mahāprabhu instead?" Hearing this, Miniketan Ramdas became somewhat unhappy. That man considered that there was some difference between Nityānanda Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahāprabhu. But there are so many stories and glories of Nityānanda Prabhu, and they are all related to Chaitanya Mahāprabhu. If someone is singing the glories of Srimati Radhika, then are they not also singing the glories of Krishna? Radhika is the dearmost of all to Krishna, and her service is the best of all. In singing the glories of Radhika, one must necessarily be glorifying Krishna. And similarly, if someone is describing the glories of Chaitanya Mahāprabhu, in doing so, they cannot but be glorifying Sri Radha and Krishna. Kaviraj Goswami's brother continued, "Such a person you are, all the time chanting Nityānanda, Nityānanda, and not glorifying Mahāprabhu, always Nityānanda, Nityānanda. But he married, whereas Mahāprabhu took sannyas, leaving his home and family." Hearing this, Miniketan Ramdas broke his flute and left that place. He was so unhappy that he broke his dearmost possession and left. At that time, Kaviraj Goswami thought to himself, "Now something inauspicious will certainly happen to my brother. How can there be any auspiciousness in his life after this?" Gradually, everything was destroyed for his brother. What do we mean by destroyed? his bhakti disappeared. There could be no worse destruction than bhakti disappearing. By the mercy of saints, one obtains bhakti. But if those saints are displeased, will our interest in bhakti remain? No. Everything was destroyed for him, and he became an atheist. So Kaviraj Goswami thought, I will not keep the company with such an atheist. I will no longer consider him my brother. If one is not favorable towards Krishna bhakti, then a friend is not a friend. A mother is not a mother. A father is not a father. And a relative is not a relative. I will not have any contact with him at all. Later that very night, at about 3 or 4 o'clock, he made the decision to leave, and very unhappily, he went away from there. Arriving at Jamatpur village, Kaviraj Goswami sat down to rest and began thinking, I cannot stay here. Where will I go? While thinking over this situation, he dozed off. Then Nityananda Prabhu appeared to him in a dream. In his hand was a golden stick. His form was very large, and he had a glossy dark luster. He had an earring on one ear, and his beauty was marvelous, just like Baladev's in Krishna Lila. He said, Why are you crying? Why are you upset? Get up, get up. Go to Vrindavan, and there place the feet of Rupa and Sanatan on your head. Go. You left your brother for me? I am very pleased with you. A real brother is one who can give bhakti. A father is one who can give instructions regarding bhakti. And a mother is one who can inspire Krishna bhakti. Your dear brother insulted me a little, and for that you have left him forever? I am very pleased. Go to Vrindavan. There you will receive darshan of Govinda, Madan Mohan, and Gopinath. You will receive the mercy of Rupa and Sanatan, and also the mercy of Vrindavan Dham itself. Go! Srila Kaviraj Goswami has written, All I did was leave my brother, and for that, Nityananda Prabhu gave me such immense mercy. One second. And for that, Nityananda Prabhu gave me such immense mercy. By that mercy, I have obtained darshan of Vrindavan Dham. What kind of darshan did he obtain? Like ours? This is the kind of darshan he received. He saw Krishna taking the cows out to graze, the gopis looking for Krishna with thirsty eyes, and the lila of Sri Radha and Krishna. And what is the meaning of the mercy of Rupa and Sanatan? By Sanatan's mercy, Kaviraj Goswami obtained some bandha gyan and scriptural knowledge. But even when one possesses this knowledge, there still may not be ras. By the mercy of Rupa Goswami, he obtains the knowledge of ras. And then he can compose such books as Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita and Govinda Lilamrita, wherein so much ras is described. The mercy of Rupa Goswami has made all this possible. In this world, even an animal will remain indebted for its entire life to someone who removes a thorn from it. In the same way, we are indebted to our Guru and the Vaishnavas. How can we be ungrateful to those who have tried to remove the thorn of material attachment from us and have tried to entice us to drink bhakti ras? Towards such Gurus and Vaishnavas, we should always be grateful. If on one day Gurudev is a little harsh with us, and in 1 minute we become ungrateful, thinking, oh, he no longer has affection for me. What ill fortune that is. We will always remain indebted to Gurudev and the Vaishnavas, and we can never repay this debt. If one doesn't understand the statement of Krishnadas Kaviraj, then that is his great misfortune. But one who understands this will never forget his indebtedness for his whole life. Even upon dying, he will not forget it. And then again, in his next birth, he will remember. This gratitude is one of the main qualities of Bhagavan himself. Although Nityananda Prabhu is Bhagavan himself, he becomes indebted to someone in the same way as Krishna became indebted to the gopis.
Naparayeham niravadya samyujam swasadu krityam vibudhayushapiva yama bhajandur jarageha shrinkala sangvrishchatadharva pratiyatu sadhuna.
Srimad Bhagavatam 10.32.22. Krishna says to the gopis, even within a long lifetime like that of the demigods, I would be unable to repay you because you have left your homes and families to serve me. Therefore, please let your own glorious deeds be your compensation. Similarly, Nityananda Prabhu says, he has broken out of the shackles of material attachment and come to engage in my service. He doesn't care at all for worldly life. Can I ever leave those who have left their family, money, and property to take up bhajan? I will never be able to do so. Kaviraj Goswami has also written,
Sankarsana karana toya shai, karbodha shai cha payobdi shai, sheshascha yasyangsha kalasanitya, nandakya rama sharanam mamastu.
It's Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Lila 5.7. May Sri Nityananda Prabhu be my shelter. Sankarshan, Sheshanag, Karunodakshai Vishnu, Garbodakshai Vishnu, and Kshiradakshai Vishnu are his plenary portions and the portions of his plenary portions. In Vaikuntha, there are different sections on the same level and other sections that are on higher levels. Incarnations such as Narasingha, Kalki, and Vaman are on the same level in Vaikuntha Dham. They share the same floor, but have their own special chambers. The lowest point is the Viraja, and then above that is Siddhaloka, which is known as the outside part of Vaikuntha. Those enemies that are killed by Bhagavan are awarded that destination. Siddhaloka is also for those who chant Aham Brahmasmi, thinking that the jiva ultimately merges into Brahman. But the jivas cannot lose their individuality. That they ultimately become one is such a lie. Yes, they meet together, just as devotees meet together and share Harikatha. As Krishna comes together with the gopis, Yashoda, and Nanda Baba, and as Ramachandra comes together with Hanuman, this meeting and coming together is done. But meeting and becoming one? Nowhere can such an example be found. Meeting, yes, but they will remain individual. The jiva never becomes Brahman. Many renowned pundits and scholars hold this theory, and thousands of people come to hear their lectures. They say that there is nothing equal to Krishna bhakti, and that the bhakti of the gopis is the best of all, and that anyone who attains devotion like that of the gopis becomes one with Brahman. They say they become one with Brahman. This type of Harikatha is completely useless. They are deceiving people, and therefore we should not attend any functions where they say that they will become one with Radha and Krishna. Yeah, actually, that's many Sahajyas. Their philosophy is completely mixed with Mayavad. Many Prakrit Sahajyas. I was just reading something about that some time ago. I was surprised. I didn't realize they were actually like, yeah. Okay. Above Siddhaloka is Sadashivaloka, and above that is Narayan Dham, where the liberated four-armed devotees reside. Salokya, Samipya, Sarupya, and Sarshti, the devotees there possess these four kinds of liberation and remain near to Narayan, serving him in Aishwarya Bhav, the mood of opulence. I think everybody knows what these mean, right? Salokya means to be on the same planet as the Lord. Samipya means to be near the Lord. Sarupya means to have the same form as the Lord. And Sarshti means to have the same kind of opulence, opulences like the Lord. Nearby are millions of special chambers, and in them are Varaha, Nrsimha, Kalki, and all other incarnations. When there is a necessity, they come to this world. Otherwise, they remain there all of the time, accepting service from their devotees. Above that is the world of Ramachandra, and above that is the world of Krishna, which is known as Goloka. In calling this Goloka, there may be some confusion, so I'll try to clarify a little. When Indra was performing the Abhishek of Krishna, he brought Surabhi there. So the residence of Surabhi is Goloka, isn't it? But don't think that Indra brought her from Goloka Vrindavan. In this Brahmanda, and in each and every Brahmanda, there is Hari Loka, the residence of Kshiradakshai Vishnu. The demigods cannot directly have Vishnu's darshan, but sometimes in his meditation, Brahma receives his darshan and attains the power to create and the strength to protect the world. In this way, each Brahmanda has its own Goloka, and this is also called Surabhi Loka, or Shvetadvip. Indra can travel up to there, and he brought Surabhi from there, saying, "You are Gomata, so please pray to Krishna for me." Therefore, this Goloka and Goloka Vrindavan are not one and the same. Similarly, the Navadvip Dham that is situated in the spiritual world is also known as Shvetadvip, but it is separate from the Shvetadvip included within this Brahmanda, wherein Kshiradakshai Vishnu resides. The lower section of Goloka Dham, below Dwarka, is where there is Swakya Bhav. Pastimes of Radha Krishna take place there. But there, Radha and Krishna are like extensions of Lakshmi Narayan in the mood of opulence. This is the destination of those who perform archana of Radha and Krishna by Vaidhi Bhakti, without aspiring for Raghunuga Bhakti. If they just perform Vaidhi Bhakti without having an aspiration for Raghunuga Bhakti, they'll reach that abode. Those who perform archana of Radha and Krishna by Vaidhi Bhakti combined with Raghunuga sentiments go either to Mathura or Dwarka. And those who have greed and fully follow Raghunuga in its pure form go to Goloka Vrindavan. That realm is in the shape of a lotus flower, and the center of that lotus is the home of Nanda. Devotees who are fully absorbed in Raghunuga Bhakti attain positions there in the pastimes of Krishna, either accompanying Krishna as he takes the cows out to graze, or as friends of Radhika. This is the highest attainment. So my Guru has explained many times that we perform Vaidhi Bhakti, of course. And Raghunuga Bhakti only starts after the stage of either Ruchi or Asakti, I think. Asakti. Yeah. That's when you begin Raghunuga Bhakti at such a high stage. But whenever we perform any of our practices, we have to have our aim clear that this is why I'm performing these practices. I'm performing it so that one day I'll have some greed and I'll be able to enter the path of Raghunuga Bhakti. But for now, if we try to jump immaturely, like, you know, prematurely, and try to start performing Raghunuga practices like that, then we'll end up taking everything cheaply and becoming sahajyas and becoming offenders. So that's why we always have to keep our aim very clear. And everything we do has to be under the guidance of Guru and Vaishnavas. Otherwise, we don't know what it means to have this mood of service and the proper way to approach these things. And so then we'll just become sahajyas, take it all cheaply and make offenses. There, Krishna is known as Vrindavan Bihari, Govinda, Shyam Sundar, and Gopinath. And his first extension is Baladev. Krishna's stick, the peacock feather in Krishna's crown, all of Krishna's paraphernalia, the gopis' paraphernalia, Vrindavan Dham, all of these are manifest by Sandhini Shakti. And the embodiment of that potency is Baladev Prabhu. The embodiment of Ladini Shakti is Radhika. And Krishna is the possessor of Chit Shakti. These three together are Sat Chid Ananda, the complete form of Krishna. Neither Radhika nor Baladev are separate from him. Together, they are one. From Baladev Prabhu alone, all the eternally perfect devotees of Krishna are manifest. And when Krishna goes to Dwarka, he becomes Vasudev, the son of Vasudev. And in Dwarka, Baladev Prabhu also feels that he is the son of Devaki. But in his original identity, he is the son of Rohini. And ultimately, Nanda Baba is Baladev's father. Not that anyone can actually be the father of Baladev, as there are fathers and sons in this world, but Nanda Baba has the identity of being his father. Nanda Baba has the strongest identity of being the father of both Krishna and Baladev. Ordinary worldly scholars cannot accept this point. They cannot understand that in whomever the identity of being Krishna's father is the most intense, that person is ultimately considered to be his father. Mostly they propound that Krishna is a son of Vasudev, and very few of them accept that he is really Nanda Nandan. Thus, Baladev Prabhu is the Vaibhav Prakash of Krishna. Wait, Baladev Prabhu is the Vaibhav Prakash? I thought he was Swayam Prakash. Or maybe... One second. I just want to look at something really quick. My friend Chandrasekhar gave me this chart. I really need to study this. It's in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Okay, yeah. That's interesting. Okay. So from Sri Krishna Swayam Bhagavan, there's Swayam Rup, Tarikatma Rup, and Avesh Rup. And so in the first one, Swayam Rup, is his direct form, himself. There's Swayam Rup and Swayam Prakash. And then from Swayam Prakash, there's the Prabhav Prakash and Vaibhav Prakash. And the Vaibhav Prakash, first is Sri Baladev. And then Chaturbhuj Vasudev. Then Dvibhuj Vasudev, and then Chaturbhuj Vyasudev. It'd be really nice to really, like, I'd like to do this sometime with everybody if you'd be interested, like, to really understand this whole chart, like, go through it really carefully. And, yeah. It's kind of embarrassing that I don't already have it all, like, really clear in my head. Okay. So, thus, Baladev Prabhu is the Vaibhav Prakash of Krishna, and he renders service to Krishna all the time. Service to Krishna is his everything, whether it is in Vrindavan, Mathura, or Dwarka. When they go to Mathura and Dwarka, taking non-different forms, they become the first Chaturvyuha. That's Vasudev, Sankarshan, Pradyumna, and Aniruddha. Then there is a second Chaturvyuha, and from the root Sankarshan comes Mahasankarshan. From Mahasankarshan comes Karnadakshai Vishnu. From Karnadakshai comes Garbhadakshai. And Garbhadakshai becomes Kshirodakshai. How does this break down the words? Rukmini Didi, is it? So Garbha is like Karana, Garbha, and Kshira. Those are the oceans, right? There's the Karana ocean, there's the Garbha ocean, and there's the Kshira ocean, the ocean of milk. And so Udaka means water, right? Udaka means water. I'm pretty sure it means water. And so, and then Shai means lying down, right? Reclining on, or like lying down. So the form lying down on the, so literally it's lying down on the waters of the Karana, and lying down on the waters of Garbha, and lying down on the water of Kshira, right? Reclining, is that the right word? So, Kshira Dakshai Vishnu then expands into countless forms as the witness in the hearts of all living beings, Paramatma. In our hearts as the witness, is that very Baladev and his Vyasti and his expansion as the Antaryami Kshira Dakshai. Kshira means milk. And just as our mother nourishes us by feeding us milk, He also sustains and nurtures us. Near Kshirodakshay Vishnu are Brahma and Shankar, and by his desire, and power, creation and destruction of the material universes take place. As Sheshnag, he has millions and millions of heads, and he is holding millions and millions of universes on his heads as if they were mustard seeds, while also taking the form of the beds on which all three Purush avatars lie. So we see in every single way, in every single manifestation, he's serving. In like the top, like in the most important, yeah. These are the six kinds of expansions of Baladeva Prabhu. From his original form in Vrindavan comes the root. Okay, so let's go through it again. The six kinds of expansions. So from his original form in Vrindavan comes the root Sankarshan, Mool Sankarshan in Mathura and Dwarka. Then Mahasankarshan in Vaikuntha. Then Karnadakshay Vishnu, Garbhodakshay Vishnu, Kshiradakshay Vishnu, and finally Shesh. One who knows these deep truths will never again have to enter the cycle of birth and death. The Purusha avatar is called Purusha because he is related to the creation of the material world. He comes into contact with Maya indirectly for the purpose of creation and management, but he himself remains separate from it. Yes, he is inside all souls, but at the same time, he is within no one. He does everything, and he inspires others to do everything, but simultaneously, he does nothing. Therefore, he is called a Purusha avatar. From this Purusha avatar come the Manvantara avatars, the Yuga avatars, and so many other incarnations. They come from Karnadakshay Vishnu, or from Garbhadakshay Vishnu, who can also be called avatari, meaning that from them avatars come forth. When Krishna comes to this world in any of his forms, then in the form of the Dham and eternal associates, Baladeva Prabhu will certainly come also. Before Krishna descends to perform pastimes in Vrindavan, Baladeva enters into the heart of Devaki and is present in her womb in the form of Sankarshan. Then Krishna himself can manifest. Krishna can't manifest in the womb of Devaki before Baladeva Prabhu manifests there in the form of Sankarshan. Therefore, Baladeva comes first in the form of the Dham and serves Krishna in that way. So just like Krishna can't enter the womb of Devaki without Baladeva Prabhu first manifesting there in the form of Sankarshan, so in the same way, Krishna can't come into our heart without Sushi Guru, Baladeva Prabhu manifesting there and making a beautiful, clean place for Krishna to enter. That's why we're completely, absolutely, 100% dependent on the mercy of Akhanda Guru Tattva, Sri Nityananda Prabhu, in the form of Sri Guru. If someone says that Krishna is an incarnation of Karnadakshay Vishnu and someone else says that he is an incarnation of Garbhadakshay Vishnu, it will cause unnecessary confusion. In some places, you'll find such descriptions. Or sometimes, Krishna is described as being born from the hair of Nar-Narayan, the Kesha avatar, an incarnation of Nar-Narayan. We may find such statements, but actually, ete changsa kala pungsa krishnastu bhagavan swayam, Srimad Bhagavatam 1.3.28. All the incarnations of Bhagavan are either plenary portions or parts of plenary portions of the Purusha avatars. But Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan himself. When it is said that Krishna himself is an incarnation, it is like a simple old lady who gives a blessing to the prime minister by saying, "My son, may you one day become the police commissioner." In her understanding, that is the highest post of all. The lady has said this with love, but she doesn't understand which position is higher. Similarly, some say that Krishna is an incarnation of Garbhadakshay or Kshiradakshay Vishnu. When Sri Ramachandra descended, Baladeva came as Lakshman. Ramachandra's pastimes are so full of separation and self-sacrifice that they make everyone cry. For apparently no reason, he deserted Sita Devi, not only once, but twice. Lakshman had not wanted Ram to go to the forest, and therefore, while they were exiled, he said to Ram, I no longer consider Maharaj Dasharath to be our father. Being excessively lusty, he is controlled by a woman, and in his old age, his intelligence has diminished. I should kill him. Look, someone is coming. If it is Bharat, I will kill him also. Bharat was coming to appease Ram. But when Lakshman climbed up a tree and saw the armies, he became very angry. Taking a bow and arrow, he started towards them. Where are you going? Ram asked. With whom will you fight? Lakshman said, Bharat has come with great pride. He wants to remove you, so there will be no obstacle to him becoming the king. Therefore, I am going now, and with one arrow, I will finish them all. But Ram was thinking that there was a misunderstanding. So he told Lakshman a story. Once there was a woman who raised a mongoose for the purpose of protecting her household from snakes. Every day she put her children to sleep on the bed, and placing the mongoose nearby, went out. One day while she was out, a snake came desiring to bite the children. The mongoose had a great fight with the snake, and with great difficulty, the mongoose killed it and protected the children. Then, being pleased with itself, the mongoose was waiting outside the house for its mistress, and there was still some blood on its mouth from the fight. The woman returned, and the mongoose went before her, saying, Coo, coo, coo. I don't know what sound mongooses make, but is it mongoose? Mongooses? I don't know. Anyways, the woman said, Where has this blood come from? You attacked the children and harmed them? Hastily, she picked up a stick and killed the mongoose. Then she went inside the house and saw the children playing. The dead snake was laying nearby. Realizing her mistake, she lamented. What a sad story. So Ram said to Lakshman, Your condition is exactly like this. First wait and see. Let Bharat come. Even the earth herself can be selfish, but Bharat can never be selfish. Nowhere in this world is there such an emblem of love like Bharat. Is there an emblem of love like Bharat? So let him come. When Bharat came, he fell at the feet of Ram and began to appease him. Seeing him offer pranam to Ram, Lakshman realized his mistake. When Bharat was leaving, Lakshman approached him alone and fell at his feet. As Bharat lifted him up and embraced him, Lakshman said, I am a great offender at your feet. I have not been able to be affectionate to you, to love you. And he began weeping bitterly. Another time, during the period when they were living in the forest, Ram ordered Lakshman to bring wood when Sita desired to enter the fire. Lakshman became very angry, but Ram said, Service rendered in the forest is the highest. You are always a servant. Lakshman accepted the order of Ram, but thought, I am making a mistake following his order. So he brought wood, and Sita Devi entered into the fire. Of course, this was a pretext by which the real Sita came out and the false Sita disappeared. But still, in the end, Lakshman took a vow that, I will not come again as your younger brother, but only as your older brother. Then things will be different, and you will not be able to treat me like this. Therefore, in the pastimes of Krishna, he came as Baladev, and in the pastimes of Mahaprabhu, he came as Nityananda Prabhu, the older brother both times. So many pastimes could be performed only as an elder brother, which from the position of a younger brother would not be possible. If Nityananda Prabhu were not present, then so many of Mahaprabhu's pastimes would have remained hidden. He was Mahaprabhu's servant, his brother and his guru also. How was he Mahaprabhu's guru? Mahaprabhu's guru was Ishwar Puri. The guru of Ishwar Puri was Madhavendra Puri. And the guru of Madhavendra Puri was Lakshmipati Tirtha. Nityananda Prabhu was also a disciple of Lakshmipati Tirtha. But because his guru departed from this world when he was at a young age, Nityananda Prabhu received nearly all his instruction from Madhavendra Puri. Whoever gives instruction on bhakti is a representative of Bhagavan, and therefore Nityananda Prabhu always considered Madhavendra Puri to be his primary guru. When Madhavendra Puri became his guru, then Ishwar Puri became his godbrother. And since Nityananda Prabhu was therefore on the level of Mahaprabhu's guru, Mahaprabhu respected him in that way. Although we see that Nityananda Prabhu had three relationships with Mahaprabhu, as a servant, a brother, and a guru, still, Nityananda Prabhu always considered himself a servant. Yes, there's a beautiful chapter in Chaitanya Charitamrita all about the glories of Advaita Prabhu, and that is the main theme throughout the whole chapter, is how everybody is in the mood of service. And he goes through all different rasas and everything, but how the mood of service is the main thing. When Mahaprabhu, especially in Mahaprabhu's pastime, everybody, there's only dasya ras. There isn't no such kind of like madhur ras or anything like that. When Mahaprabhu was absorbed in kirtan, generally it was Nityananda Prabhu who protected him. Dhori, what is it? Dhori len, Doriyabulen Nityananda Mahabali. When Mahaprabhu was dancing in his usual way, Nityananda Prabhu would catch him for his own protection. And only when Mahaprabhu became absorbed in Radha Bhav could Nityananda Prabhu not touch him. Nityananda Prabhu would engage in all types of service, always following the order of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu told him, "Please go to Bengal. The Brahmins there, being very proud, don't perform bhajan of Bhagavan. Preach something to the Brahmin class. But mostly, preach to those who are considered fallen in society, because they are not really fallen. Each and every soul has the right to perform Bhagavad Bhajan. Please go." So Nityananda Prabhu went there, preached from village to village, and made disciples of everyone. Once, Nityananda Prabhu was going along the road with a preaching party when he came across a village where there lived a wealthy landowner named Ramachandra Khan. Nityananda Prabhu entered the man's home and sat down on the altar of the Durga Mandap. As previously in Bengal, the wealthy people would have such mandaps, canopies raised for ceremonial purposes, for Chandi or Durga. He was thinking, night is falling, so where can we possibly go now? Tomorrow morning, we will continue on our way. Meanwhile, Ramachandra Khan sent one of his servants to speak to Nityananda Prabhu. Sarcastically, the man said, "There is not enough space for you here in the house, but we have a goshala, which is a very pure place due to the presence of cows and cow dung. Saints and sadhus should stay there, so go to the goshala." When Nityananda Prabhu heard this, he became angry and said, "Yes, you are right. This place is unfit for me. It is fit for cow-killing meat-eaters." Saying this, he left that place. The next day, Muslims attacked and arrested Ramachandra Khan and his entire family. They also killed a cow, cooked the meat, and ate it on that very spot. The entire village was destroyed. Nityananda Prabhu has two aspects. Just like a mother lion. To her cubs, the lion is very kind. But to others, she is very dangerous. Similarly, Nityananda Prabhu is supremely merciful. He is supremely merciful to the devotees and is a subduer of atheists. So he's very merciful to the devotees and he is the subduer of the atheists. Was it Pashanda Kanda Nityananda Sangirangi Bitare? There's a couple other verses. Anyways, just as Baladeva Prabhu holds a plow and club and killed Dvivida the gorilla and others who are inimical to Krishna, so Nityananda Prabhu subdues the atheists and increases Gaur Prem in devotees. We should never consider there to be any difference between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. There is a difference in body only. Nityananda Prabhu is the complete Guru Tattva, and wherever there is Guru, he is there. Wherever there is Guru, Nityananda Prabhu is there. Wherever the activities of Guru are performed, the message of Krishna is given to the jivas. Wherever the activities of Guru are performed, the message of Krishna is given to the jivas that by bhakti only will there be real auspiciousness. This is all manifested by Nityananda Prabhu. Therefore, on this day, we offer pranam unto He who is the most merciful and the most complete. Who is the most merciful and the complete Guru Tattva. And we pray that he will always be merciful to us. Shri Nityananda Ram ki jai. Okay, so that was from this book, A Treasury of Holy Days, and now we will move on to this article by excerpts from an article by Śrīla Bhakti Rakshak Śrīla Gosvāmī Mahārāja. Wait, let me open up a new window so that I can see the comments. There, okay. So this is, if anybody wants to find what I'm reading now, it's on Vine of Devotion. That's my website, vineofdevotion.com. And it should be, I think I posted it a long time ago, so I think I'll have to just type it in search. Just type in Nityānanda and you'll find it, I think. Yeah, there, see? Just type in Nit in search, then it'll come up, the first thing. The glories of Nityānanda. And it says that this will take 8 minutes to read, so we might go a little bit over time today. Well, we have 8 minutes, but I'm saying overtime because I wanted to sing Nityānandāṣṭakam at the end. So this, what we're going to read now, I also made like a good quality recording of it, like an audiobook kind of recording, which you can find here. You can listen there. All right. Actually, let's read it in here just so that I can make the text big. Open in reader. There. Okay. 1 second. Okay. So below are two excerpts from glorifications by Śrīla Bhakti Rakshak Śrīdhara Gosvāmī Mahārāja that I found on the Śrī Caitanya Sarasvat Mart's website, Śrī Gaudiya Darshan, and chapter 4 of Śrī Guru and His Grace. Okay. So this is Śrīla Bhakti Rakshak Śrīdhara Gosvāmī Mahārāja. And you can find the whole article. I give the link on this website if you want to read the full article. This is just a little excerpt. Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu is there to consolidate the ground, the foundation. That will help us to make further progress. Speedy progress without a good foundation may invite reactions. Our foundation comes from Nityānanda Prabhu, Gurudev. That the foundation will not go away is the primary necessity. Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu's mercy sometimes exceeds that of Śrī Caitanya Dev. Nityānanda Prabhu's mercy exceeds that of Śrī Caitanya Dev. Caitanya Dev sometimes cannot accept the fallen. If a bad precedent may be created by doing so, then he cannot accept them. So he has to consider someone's status and position and other things. But Nityānanda Prabhu's mercy does not care for any unfavorable circumstances. Mahaprabhu has to consider someone's status and position and other things, but Nityānanda Prabhu's mercy does not care for any unfavorable circumstances. It is so lavish and blind. I love that. It is so lavish and blind. It does not differentiate between sinners of different degrees. It is all-embracing. And Mahaprabhu cannot dismiss Nityānanda Prabhu's recommendation. This is a connection we are given to understand. Nityānanda Prabhu gave shelter even to those whom Mahaprabhu rejected. And gradually, Mahaprabhu had to accept them. So the magnitude and circumference of Nityananda's grace is the greatest. For us, the most fallen souls, that is our solace. Jai, Nityānanda Prabhu ki jai. Bhaja Gauranga kaho Gauranga loho Gaurange namare je jano Gauranga bhaje she hoya mar pranare. Nityānanda Prabhu's duty is concentrated on bringing everyone to Gauranga. He calls everyone to fall at the feet of Gauranga. Nothing more is necessary. All else, the highest fortune will be attained automatically. He simply calls out, Sorry, he simply calls out, collects souls, and throws them in the dust of Gauranga's feet. Nothing else is necessary. Whoever they may be, a Muslim, a low-class person, or otherwise. Scholarship and so-called moral or material purity are not necessary. No need to have any moral or material purity. Nothing we see, Jagai and Madai, right? Scholarship, so-called moral and material purity are not necessary. If anyone, even if they are the lowest type, gets connection with the feet of Gauranga, then all their disqualifications may be removed in a second. Gauranga is such a touchstone, and everything he converts does not become a middle-class jewel. It becomes a jewel of the highest class. He is such a touchstone. Nityananda used to roam along both sides of the Ganga, calling out to one and all, "Come, join the camp of Sri Gauranga. Bhaja Gauranga, kaho Gauranga, laho Gaurange namare. Je jana Gauranga bhaje, she hoyamar pranare." The life of my life is one who has come to take shelter under the direction of my Lord Gauranga. O fallen souls, gather round and beg my Lord Gauranga for his grace. Automatically, you will find yourself in Vrindavan. All the undesirable things within you will be cleared in no time. And unconsciously, your pristine inner self will emerge and find suddenly that it is in the midst of the desired soil, Vrindavan, which is filled with the most wonderful paraphernalia. You will find you are at home, back at home. Get a ticket here in Navadvip, and you will quickly reach your home. We will get everything by the most magnanimous heart of Nityananda Prabhu. He no nitai bine bhai, Radha Krishna paite nai, Dridha kori dharo nitai bhai, Dridha kori dharo nitai bhai. Firmly catch the holy feet of Nityananda. All else will come to you automatically. Gauranga will come, and when Gauranga comes, everything comes. Okay, so that was from that class of Śrīla Bhakti Rakshak Śrīla Gosvāmī Mahārāja. And now we're going to read this excerpt from chapter 4 of Śrī Guru and His Grace. The title of this section is The Original Guru. The original spiritual master is Nityānanda Prabhu. He is the general representation of Guru. In the spiritual world, he is the Guru Tattva principle in the four primary mellows of devotion, excluding the conjugal mellow. In Madhur Ras, Baladev's representation is Ananga Manjari, the sister of Radharani. So that's why we're hearing from my Gurudev when Mahaprabhu is absorbed in Radhabhav, at that time, Nityananda Prabhu won't touch him because Baladev Prabhu, that would be Rasabhas. But Baladev Prabhu's representation is Ananga Manjari, the sister of Radharani. The position of Nityananda is greater than that of Baladev. Why? He is distributing prema, divine love. And what is prema? It is higher than all other achievements. If one can give divine love, then all others must be subordinate to him. If Krishna is subordinate to Mahaprabhu, then of course, Balaram is subordinate to Nityananda. I like this. If one can give divine love, then all others must be subordinate to him. If Krishna is subordinate to Mahaprabhu, then of course Balaram is subordinate to Nityananda. They are similar, but when magnanimity is added, Baladev becomes Nityananda. That Balaram who can distribute divine love, who can perform that higher function, has come here as Nityananda. Our foundation must be solid and proper. The structure should be erected. Otherwise, the whole thing will go down. Heno nitai bine bhai radha krishna paitinai. We can get a solid foundation from Nityananda Prabhu. One day, Nityananda Prabhu came to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's house in Mayapur. Mahaprabhu's mother, Shachi Devi, and Vishnupriya Devi, his wife, were also there, as well as other devotees. Suddenly, Nityananda arrived quite naked. Mahaprabhu managed to give him some cloth, and perhaps he was concerned that the devotees might have some misconception about Nityananda Prabhu. So to prevent this, he asked Nityananda Prabhu for his kopan, his loincloth. He tore it up and distributed it amongst the householders that were present, instructing them, "Keep a piece of his loincloth as a kavacha, as an amulet, and tie that with your a thread around your arm or wear it around your neck. Keep it with you. Then you will be able to achieve sense control very soon." Nityananda Prabhu has control of his senses to the extreme degree. He does not know anything of this world. His vairagya, his indifference to the world of mundane transaction, is of such a degree that he can appear naked amongst both male and female. So the grace of Nityananda Prabhu will construct a firm foundation for us. If there is a firm foundation, then we may build a great structure over it. If we have faith in Nityananda, then that faith can bear any amount of weight. It won't betray us. If we have faith in Nityananda, then that faith can bear any amount of weight. It won't betray us. So Śrīla Bhaktivedānta Swami Prabhupāda has laid stress amongst the Westerners on devotion to Nityananda. First, we must get his mercy. And then afterwards, we can get the mercy of Radha Krishna. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu means Radha Krishna. Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nahe Anya. First achieve the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, and then Gauranga Mahaprabhu, and then Sri Radha Govinda. In these three stages, we must raise ourselves up. Kishore mentioning, like on the previous point that I mentioned, once during Ratayatra, Nitai saw Mahaprabhu directly as Radharani. At that time, he simply offered pranams from a distance. Okay, so first we achieve the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, then Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then Radha Govinda. In these three stages, we must raise ourselves up. Then a devotee asks, "How does one attain the mercy of Lord Nityananda?" Then Śrīla Śrīdhara Gosvāmī Mahārāja says, "One who finds more inclination to serve Gauranga and his dham, his transcendental land, and his servants, can get the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda is very much kind to one who has some special tendency towards Gaur-līlā." And now we're going to find an example. Śrīla Śrīdhara Gosvāmī Mahārāja is going to explain an example of this, of how Nityananda Prabhu is very kind to one who has some special tendency towards Gaur-līlā. I'll see. "Take the name of Gauranga. Nityananda Prabhu walked from door to door in Bengal, saying, 'Take the name of Gauranga. I'll become your servant. You can purchase me if you only take the name of Gauranga. I will be sold to you without any price or condition.' That was his temperament. When Mahaprabhu was in Puri, he sent Nityananda Prabhu to Bengal. At that time, he said, 'Without you, I don't find anyone who can spread the name of Krishna, our devotional service to Krishna in Bengal. They are more engaged in the tantric method and smriti. They make too much of these trifling things. They are puffed up, thinking that they have finished all knowledge. So Bengal is a very hard field for preaching. Without you, no one will be able to awaken the masses. Separate yourself from the higher castes and approach the masses with the holy name of Krishna. You are the fittest person for this work.'" Okay, so Mahaprabhu was telling Nityananda Prabhu to spread the holy name of Krishna. Let's see how Nityananda Prabhu followed this order of Mahaprabhu to spread the holy name of Krishna. and devotional service to Krishna. Nityananda Prabhu went to Bengal, but without trying to preach the glories of the holy name of Krishna, Nityananda Prabhu began to preach the name of Gauranga. Nityananda Prabhu found that there is some danger in thinking that Krishna's pastimes are very much akin to the mundane debauchery, lying, and stealing of a degraded soul. Krishna's pastimes are of a very highly confidential nature. It is very difficult for the masses to understand the purity of Krishna Lila. The mass mind cannot accept Krishna's Lilas as the highest attainment. So Nityananda Prabhu found it would be difficult to preach Krishna Lila. But he found it would be easy to preach Gaur Lila, where Krishna has come to distribute himself to the public with so much capital in his mind. Gauranga means a dynamo. What's the actual definition of a dynamo? I just want to see. Dynamo is a device that changes energy from the movement of things such as wind or water into electricity. A machine for converting mechanical energy into electrical energy, a generator. Okay. So Gauranga means a dynamo. Dynamo, which wants to distribute Krishna surcharged with the most magnanimous, intensified pity and kindness for the ordinary people, with the greatest affection, even for the criminals. Wow. Gauranga means a dynamo which wants to distribute Krishna surcharged with the most magnanimous, intensified pity and kindness for the ordinary people, with the greatest affection, even for the criminals. Nityananda Prabhu wanted to bring them in connection with Gauranga, that Gauranga, for then Krishna Lila would automatically be within our fists. So he began to preach about Gauranga, not Radha Krishna, as commanded by Mahaprabhu. No, he didn't follow that instruction of Mahaprabhu. He preached about Mahaprabhu instead. So Nityananda Prabhu says, Bhaja Gauranga, Kaha Gauranga, Laha Gaurange Namare. Worship Gauranga. Speak only of Gauranga and chant the name of Gauranga. There is another instance of the relationship between Krishna and Balaram and Gauranga and Nityananda, which is described in the Chaitanya Bhagavat. This story is so much fun. Shachi Devi had a dream that Krishna and Balaram were sitting on the throne and Nityananda was fighting with Balaram. Nityananda said to Balaram in Shachi Mata's dream, come down from the throne. It is no longer Dwapara Yug. The age of Kali has come, and my master Gauranga must occupy your position on this throne. You come down. Then Balaram began giving some opposition. No, no, no. Why should we come down? We have been sitting on this throne for such a long time. Then Nityananda Prabhu began forcibly taking him down, and Balaram submitted slightly. Nityananda Prabhu said, My master Gauranga wants to take the position now. The age for him has come. So Nityananda is very partial to Gauranga. He says, Krishna is far off. My lord is Gauranga. So we must be very grateful to Nityananda Prabhu, for he is our guru. And guru's grace is so important that Raghunath Das Goswami says, O Radharani, I want your grace. Without you, I don't want Krishna separately. I never want Krishna without you. That should be the healthy attitude of a devotee. This has been explained by Śrīla Viśvanātha Chakravarti Thakur in his Gurvashtakam. Yasya prasadar. Sorry, I'm just trying to think of the melody. Anyways. Yasya prasadar bhagavat prasado. Yasya prasada nagati kutopi. Dhyayang stuvangstasya yashastri sandhyam. Vande guru shi charanaravindam. I bow down to the lotus feet of Sri Gurudev. By his grace, we achieve the grace of Krishna. Without his grace, we are lost. Therefore, we should always meditate on Sri Gurudev and pray for his mercy. This is a position of Sri Guru, by whose grace we can get everything. We can get the grace of Krishna, and without whose grace, we have no other prospect. So in this way, we must have reverence for he who has given us our first connection with Krishna consciousness. Jai Śrīla Gurudeva ki jai, Jai Śrīla Prabhupāda ki jai, Jai Svaparikāra Śrīla Prabhupāda ki jai, Jai Akhanda Guru Tattva Śrīman Nityānanda Prabhu ki jai. Hari Bol. Wow. Such amazing Harikatha, such amazing glorification of Nityānanda Prabhu. So, if anybody wants this, you can find it on my website, vineofdevotion.com. Just type in Nityānanda in the search. So now we will end with, maybe we can sing Nityānandāṣṭakam and what else? Rāda Deshanam, Eka Chakragram. Maybe we'll sing that first. The Nityānanda Prabhu Āvirbhāva-līlā kīrtana. Where is it? The last place I sent it out was, one second, it should be, I'll find it in one second. I sent it out on the Gaudiya Kirtan mailing list yesterday. Actually, it should be here in this post, on that same thing. Where is it? Sorry, give me one second. Whatever. I think I know where else to find it. It's here. Why is it not loading? Sorry, guys. Give me one second. Maybe I could just get it on my computer. Rāda Deshanam. Oops, why is that? There it is. Sorry, guys. Here. Okay, the appearance of Śrīman Nityānanda Prabhu. This is written by Krishadas. In the country named Rad, in the village of Eka Chakra, at the house of Harai Pandit, Haladar, the carrier of the plow, appeared in the auspicious month of Magh, on the 13th day of the bright lunar fortnight. Completely ecstatic, Harai Pandit held a grand festival, and Mother Earth trembled, unable to contain her bliss. The Lord of Shantipur, Sri Advaita Acharya, having deduced the time of Nityānanda Prabhu's appearance, was overjoyed at heart. He understood that Balaram, the elder brother of Sri Krishna, had appeared. The hearts of the Vaishnavas were delighted, and they floated in an ocean of bliss. The morose Krishnadas says, "This lowly wretch will surely be saved." Okay. Let me just get the mridanga.
O Rāda Deshanam, Eka Chakra Gram, Harai Pandita Gaur.
Just making sure, okay, got the sound okay.
Rāda Deshanam, Eka Chakra Gram, Harai Pandita Gara. Shubha Magha Masi Shukla Trayodaśī. Shubha Magha Masi Shukla Trayodaśī. Janamila Haladhar. Janamila Haladhar. Shukla Trayodaśī Janamila Haladhar. Janamila Haladhar. Harai Pandita Ati harashita putra mahotsava kore dharani manda kore tala mala dharani manda kore tala mal anandana hi patha Shanti Puranat Mane Harashita Kori Kichu Anuman Ayantare Janila Bujhi Janamila Antare Janila Bujhi Janamila Krishner Agrajara Vaishnava Raman Hoilo Parasanna Ananda Sagare Bhashe Vaishnava Raman Hoilo Parasanna Ananda Sagare Bhashe Edina Pamar Hoibe Odar Edina Pamar Hoibe Odar Kohe Duki Krishna Da Radesha naam Eka chakra grama Harai pandita ghara Radesha naam Eka chakra grama Harai pandita ghara Shubha magamashi Shukla trayodashi Shubha magamashi Shukla trayodashi Dashi jana mila halada, jana mila halada. Jaya Nityānanda Ram, Jaya Nityānanda Ram, Nityānanda Ram, Jaya Nityānanda Ram, Jaya Nityānanda Ram, Nityānanda Ram. Parmavati Nandana Nityānanda Ram, Jaya Nityānanda Ram, Jaya Nityānanda Ram. Parmavati Nandana Nityānanda Ram. Nityānanda Ram, Jaya Nityānanda Ram, Harai Nandana Nityānanda Ram.
All right, so now we will sing Gurudeva-štakam and then, sorry, my mind, I'm just going to stop talking and I'll just do whatever. Sorry. Okay, Nityānandāṣṭakam, that's what it's called. Okay. Okay, so the sphere of his bright face resembles a wandering autumnal moon. His pure complexion glistens. His gait is like that of an elephant. He is utterly intoxicated in Krishna Prem, and he is the personification of pure spiritual energy, Vishuddha Sattva. His face is smiling. His eyes are ever rolling. His hand holds a staff, and by the performance of Nam Sankirtan, he dispels the forces of Kali. I perpetually worship Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree. You know what I'm going to do this time? I've never done this before, I don't think. I'm going to read each translation and then sing the verse so that we know what we're singing. Because if I just read all the translations now and then we go back to the verses, we'll forget everything, like what is contained in each verse. So I'm going to do it like that. Okay.
Sharaj Chandra Brantem Spuradamalakantem Gajagatem Hari Premon
mata trita parama satvam smitamukam sada gurna netram karakalita vetram kalibhidam bhaje nityanadam bhajanataru kandam niravadi.
This is written by Śrīla Vṛndāvanadāsa Thakur. He is the abode of all rasas. He is everything to the devotees. He is beyond compare. And he is the dear husband of Vasudha and Janavadevi, who are his very life. He is always maddened in prem, and he is unknown only to those of mundane intelligence. I perpetually worship Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree.
Rasanam agaram swajana gana sarva swamatulam tadiyaika prana pratima vasudha jana vapate sada premonmadam parama viditam manda manasam bhaje nityanandam bhajana tarukandam niravadi.
He is most dear to Mother Shakti's son. He is worshipped by the entire universe, and he is bursting with joy. By his unbounded mercy, he rescues the souls drowning in this age of Kali, and by performing Śrī Harinam Sankirtan, he evaporates the swelling pride in this ocean of mundane existence. I perpetually worship Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree.
Oh, Shachi Suno Preshta Nikila Jagadishtam Sukhamayam Kalo Majja Jivo Dharana Karano Dama Karunam Hare Rakhya Narva Bhava Jaladi Karvon Nati Haram Bhaje Nityanandam Bhajana Tarukandam Niravadi.
Oh, my brother Gauranga, contaminated by the vices of Kali Yuga, what will become of mankind? He thus advises the Supreme Lord Śrī Krishna Chaitanya. He says, please devise a purificatory method whereby they can easily attain your shelter. I perpetually worship Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree.
Oh, aye brother nrina Kali kalushinam king nu bhavita tata prayaschitam rachaya yadanaya sata ime vrajanti twametam saha bhagavata mantrayatiyo bhaje nityananda bhajana tarukandam niravadi.
Oh brothers, simply chant incessantly the names of Śrī Hari, and let the responsibility of delivering you from the ocean of repeated birth and death rest upon me. While traveling constantly, he approached the door of every home, declaring this with outstretched arms. I perpetually worship Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree.
Yateshtam re brata Guru Hari Hari Dvana Manisham Tatova Sangsara Buditarana Dayo Mayi Laget Idang Bahu Spotar Atatiratayanya Pratigriham Bhaje Nityanandam Bhajanataru Kandam Niravadi.
How astonishing! He is just like Agastya Muni, who once swallowed the entire ocean, forcibly swallowing the ocean of repeated birth and death. He is the rising moon that causes the ocean of saintly persons' good fortune to swell. He is the brilliant sun, blazing before the multitude of rogues and dispelling the darkness of their ignorance. I perpetually worship Śrī Nityānanda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree. Sorry, it's hard for me to play this beat and read it. the same time. Oh, palat sangsarambo nidhiharana kumbod bavamaho satam sheya sindun nati komoda bandom samodita kalashini spurjati mirahara surya prabhamaho paje nityananda Bhajana taru kandam niravadi. Dancing, singing, and calling out the names of Sri Hari and delighting his own associates who are absorbed in Sri Hari Nam Kirtan with his darshan, he roams each and every path, casting merciful glances upon the saintly from the corners of his eyes. I perpetually worship Sri Nityananda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree. Natantam gayantam hare manuvadantam pati pati vrajantam pashyantam swamapi nadayantam janagana prakurvantam santam sakarunadrikantam prakalanat bhaje nityananda Janataru Kandam Niravadi. He gently held the supremely soft lotus hand of his brother, their hearts soaring upward in the highest bliss as they gazed at each other's faces. As he wandered here and there, he delighted the townspeople with his sweetness. I perpetually worship Sri Nityananda Prabhu, the root of the Krishna Bhakti tree. Subibranam Bratu Karasarasi Jamko Malataram Nito Vakra Loko Chalita Paramananda Hridayam Brahmantam Madhuryar Ahaha Madayantam Purajanam Paje Nityananda Janataru Kandam Niravadi. May Sri Nityananda Prabhu's two lotus feet brilliant manifest in the hearts of those who recite this unprecedented and supremely potent Nityānandāṣṭakam, which is the reservoir of ras, the treasure of exalted rasik Vaishnavas, and the abode of the essence of bhakti ras. It bestows liberation upon all fallen souls who simply remember it.
Rasanam adaram rasika vara sarvaishnavadhanam rasagaram saram patita tatitaram smaranata param nityananda ashtakam idam apurvam patati yas tarangri tvantvabjam spuratu nitaram tasya hridaye bhaje nityanandam bhajanataru kandam niravadi bhaje nityanandam Bhajanataru Kandam Niravadi. Jaya Nityananda Ram, Jaya Nityananda Ram, Nityananda Ram, Jaya Nityananda Ram, Jaya Nityananda Ram, Nityananda Ram, Nityananda Ram, Jaya Nityananda Ram.
Jaya Shri Nityananda Ram Ki Jaya. There are two songs that we're going to be adding into the songbook. They're really beautiful. I just finished a translation for them yesterday, and I sent them to Vaijantimala for editing. So they're not totally. I'm not sure. Like the English will be not so nice in it. But you want to see it? They're really nice. We'll go in the new Goriya Gitikucha. Let me just find it. If anybody needs to go, you can go. Okay, so this is, one is Are Bhai Nitai Amar Doyar Abadi, and the other is Dekho Nitai Chander Madhuri. This is, both these songs describe the beauty, the form of Nityananda Prabhu. Rup Kirtan. So the first one, this is the first one is by Lochandas Thakur. We'll sing it really quickly because I know it's getting late. So Lochandas Thakur says, "Just behold the sweetness of the moon-like Nitai." Oh, and Rukmini Didi, if there's anything that should be changed in the translation, if anything's not accurate, please mention, because this is going to go in the songbook. So, okay. "Just behold the sweetness of the moon-like Nitai. The horripilation covering his body resembles the stamen of a kadamba flower. Raising his arms, he chants, 'Hari, Hari.' The abode of his lotus face defeats the beauty of millions of cupids. How has providence created such a face? Has it churned the ocean of beauty, scooped out the moon, and crafted his face from nectar?" The word ningariya means squeezes, and like, I was thinking maybe like it means like from the ocean of beauty. You know, like how the moon appeared from the when during the Mantar Mandan, you know, like the churning of the ocean, then the moon came from that and Shiva put that on his crown, right? So I was wondering if there's some connection with that. And I was thinking Ningariya, which literally means to squeeze or to that, that maybe it's like extracted. But anyways, Shiva's helped me with this one. So he said scooped out the moon. Anyways, so has providence churned the ocean of beauty, scooped out the moon, and crafted his face from nectar? His eyes resemble fresh lotus petals, and his pupils are like bumblebees or birds who are submerged in the flower of in the flower nectar of prema. Whoever saw that beauty realized it to be clouds of ras. The entire earth floated in the bliss of prema." I think I'm getting something wrong with this here also. I don't think I'm getting the connection. "He who previously reveled in the land of Raj, in Nanda Maharaja's home as Mother Rohini's son, Balaram, is now Parmavati's son, Nityananda Avadut. He is known as the savior of the universe. Witnessing the degraded condition of the living entities, that Lord mercifully descended and made them chant the names of Gaur Hari. Having fallen into the shackles of material existence, the blind Lochandas weeps, for he is unable to behold the sweetness of that form." Oh, that's very helpful. Thank you, Rukmini Didi. I'm going to save that. Okay. I'm going to sing this quick, like in a fast melody, though, so we can get through. "O dekho nitai chandera madhuri, pula ke pura latano, kadamba ke shara jano, bahu tuli bole hari hari. Shri Mukha Mandala Dham, Jini Koto Koti Kam, Sena Vidi Kise Nira Milo, Mathiala Vanya Sindhu, Tahe Ningariya Indu, Sudha Diya Mukhani Garilo, Sudha Diya Mukhani Garilo. Navakanja dala anki, taraka brahmara pati, dubi rahu prema makarande. Ashe rupa dekhilo jeha, se janilo rasa meho, avani bhashalo premanande. Purabe je braja pure bihare, nandir ghare, Rohini Nandana Balaram. Ebe Parmavati Suta Nityananda Yavaduta Bhuvana Pavana Huelo Nam. She Pahu Patita Heri Karunaya Avatari Jivere Bolai Gorahari. Poriya She Bhava Bande Kandailo Chanayande Nadekia Sherupa Madhuri, Nadekia Sherupa Madhuri. Yeah, but this verse also, because you know how the moon is called Sudakar? It's always mentioning how nectar emanates from the rays of the moon, and that's what sustains all the plants and all the living entities. So I think there must be some connection with that Sudadiya and the moon, the Indu. I actually translated this a different way, and then I gave it to Shivas, because the way I translated it was a little bit strange. Anyways, let's move on to Nitai Amar Doyar Abadi. Okay. Oh, brothers, this is by Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur. Okay. Oh, brothers. This is a really rough translation. Okay. Oh, brothers, my Nitai embodies the ultimate limit of mercy. Overflowing with compassion for the living beings, he wanders from one place to another, incessantly begging them to accept the treasure of Prem. I need to get this checked. Because Jache means begs. And so, but he's not begging from them the treasure of Prem, so it must be that he's begging them to accept the treasure of Prem. But anyways. As he engages in banter with Sri Advaita Acharya, he loses control over his bodily movements, as that form is composed of Gaur Prem. Staggering forward, arms raised, he calls out the names of Hari as tears cascade from his two eyes. Radiant tilak decorates his forehead, and his curling locks gracefully sway. Bound around his topknot is a necklace of gunjaberries. His waist, surpassing that of a lion, is adorned with a blue dhoti. Ankle bells tinkle upon his reddish lotus feet. His enchanting appearance captivates the entire world and inundates all lands. Submerged in rus, he roars in joyous laughter. My Nityananda Prabhu is indeed the sole source of all divine bliss. Thus, Vrindavan Das sings his glories. Isn't that such a beautiful song? Are bhai nitai Nitai amar doyar abadi are bhai nitai amar doyar abadi jivere koruna kori deshe deshe firi firi prema dana jache nirabadi prema dana jache nirabadi Advaitera sange ranga dharanena jai anga gora preme gada thanu khani dhuliya dhuliya chale bahu tuli hari bole dunayane bahe nitar pani kopale tilak shobe kutila kuntala lole Gunjahar atuni chura chatai Gunjahar atuni chura thai Oke shari jini akoti Koti tate nila dhoti Koti tate nila dhoti Bajanu puranga pai Bajanu puranga pai Ranga pai Bhuvana Mohana Vesh Majaila Shabadesh Rasaveshe Atta Atta Haas Prabhu Mora Nityananda Kevalaya Nanda Kanda Prabhu Mora Nityananda Kevalaya Nanda Kanda Kona Gai Vrindavana Das Kona Gai Vrindavana Oh, Prabhu Mora Nityananda Kevalaya Ananda Kanda Prabhu Mora Nityananda Kevalaya Ananda Kanda Guna Gai Vrindavana Das Guna Gai Vrindavana Das Are Bhai Nitai Amar Doyara Avadi Are Bhai Nitai Amar Doyara Avadi Jaya Nityananda Nityananda Ram, Jaya Nityananda Ram, Nitai He, Nitai He.
nitai he, nitai he, nitai he, nitai he. Oh, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Nitai Gaur, Hari Bol, Nitai Gaur, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
Oh, Gopikant Prabhu, he's saying, Hare Krishna Prabhu, I'm not able to find the Nityananda Prabhu Janam Lila Kirtan. Can I please provide it? The Nityananda Prabhu Janam, are you, anybody who's not on the Gaudiya Kirtan mailing list wouldn't have received it, but if you are on the Gaudiya Kirtan mailing list, you'll have it. I can also give the link here, what I just opened here on, I'll send the link right now. One second. Okay, I am posting the link on Facebook. Wait. Where is it? Okay, so it's not going to come on Facebook. If you go to YouTube, you'll find the link there. I just put the link on YouTube. On the YouTube, it will be in the YouTube chat. But for some reason, it doesn't. Oh. And it's also, if you go to the GVP page, it will also be on the GVP page chat. For some reason, it won't go to my personal page, though. I can't send messages there for some reason. But yeah, if anybody wants that Radha Deshanam Eka Chakra Gram Harai Pandita Ghar, that kirtan about Nityananda Prabhu's appearance, you can find it there in the chat. All right, I'm going to do Jaidwani, and then I have to rush to Mayapur. I'm kind of late.
Jai Shishi Guru Guranga Gandharvika Giridhari Shishi Radha Vinod Bihari Juki Jai Shi Govinda Gopinath Maran Mohan Juki Jai Nityalala Pravishtam Vishnupa Rashata Rashata Shishmar Bhaktivedanta Narayan Gosvami Maharaj Shila Gurudeva Ki Jai Nityalala Pravishtam Vishnupa Rashata Rashata Shishmar Bhaktivedanta Vaman Gosvami Maharaj Ki Jai Nityalala Pravishtam Vishnupa Shishmar Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Shila Prabhupada Ki Jai Nityalala Pravishtam Vishnupa Shila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Gosvami Maharaj Ki Jai Nityalila Pravishna Vishnupada Shatarashita Shimar Shila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasati Gosvami Prabhupada Ki Jai Nityalila Pravishna Maha Bhagavat Shila Gaur Kishorada Swabaji Maharaj Ki Jai Nityalila Pravishna Shila Satchidananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur Ki Jai Nityalila Pravishna Vaishnav Sarvabhoma Shila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj Ki Jai Shri Rupanu Gauriya Guru Varga Ki Jai Shri Rupa Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath Shri Jeev Gopala Bhatta Das Raghunath Sharda Gosvami Prabhu Ki Jai Shri Sarup Damada Rai Ramanandari Shri Gaur Parshad Vrinda Ki Jai Namachai Shil Haridas Thakur Ki Jai Prem Se Koho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasari Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai Shri Kshetra Mandala Gaura Mandala Vraja Mandala Mathura Vrindavan Dham Ki Jai Sarva Avishta Pradatta Giriraj Maharaj Ki Jai Shri Radha Kunda Shama Kunda Ki Jai Shri Yamuna Devi Ganga Devi Ki Jai Shri Tulsi Maharani Vrinda Devi Ki Jai Shri Bhakti Devi Ki Jai Shri Purnamasi Yogamaya Ki Jai Shri Gopeshwar Mahadev Ki Jai Jai Shri Nityananda Prabhu Ki Jai Karuna Avatar Shri Nityananda Prabhu Ki Jai Jai Shri Patit Pavan Shri Savior of the Fallen Souls Nityananda Prabhu Ki Jai Jai Shri Nityananda Trayodaśī Titi Ki Jai Titi Palan Kari Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai Jai Eka Chakra Gram Ki Jai Shri Hadai Pandit Ki Jai Shri Parmavati Devi Ki Jai And Nityananda Prabhu Shaktis, Vasudha Janava Devi Ki Jai. Nityananda Prabhu's son, Veera Chandra Prabhu Ki Jai. I think his daughter's name is Ganga Devi, I think. Ki Jai. Then Nityananda Prabhu's associates, the Dwadash Gopal Ki Jai. Jai. Swaparshad Shri Gaur Nityananda Prabhu Ki Jai. Shri Harinam Sankirtana Ki Jai. Ananta Koti Vaishna Vrinda Ki Jai. Samagata Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai. Shri Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bo Jai Shri Śrīman Nityānanda Prabhu Ki Jai Vrindai Tulsi Devai Priyai Keshavashacha Krishna Bhakti Prada Devi Satyavatar Namo Namaha Vancha Kalpataru Bhyashcha Kripa Sindhu Bhyai Vacha Patitanam Pavane Bhyo Vaishnave Bhyo Namo Namaha
Dandavat pranams, everybody. Thank you so much for it. Wow, this program went way over time. thank you for sticking till the end. And Dandavat pranams, Nari Hari Prabhu and Pavatarini Mataji. Jai Shri. Oh my God. You're probably wondering like why I haven't left yet. We're supposed to start the program in Mayapur. Well, officially it's supposed to start in 15 minutes from now, and it takes me like an hour to get to Mayapur, so yikes. Subhadra Devi, Dandavat pranams, Krishna Mai Didi, Champak Mataji, and let's see who's on YouTube and Facebook. Brinda Didi, Ganga Mataji, Raseshwari Mataji, Vidyalalasa Didi, Rajbhuvan Yadavji, Rukmini Didi, Kishore Prabhu, Vidyalalasa Didi. Kishore's voice is lost from the ecstatic kirtan. That's great. Vangsiwala Prabhu, Haribol, everybody. Indira Mataji, Haribol, Indira Mataji. Who else is there? Gargarajji, Gopikant Prabhu, and everybody else. Jai, Haribol, Haribol. Thank you so much for joining, and I'll see you all tomorrow to continue our reading from Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat. We're soon going to be starting the Mahaprabhu taking sannyas. We have 3 chapters left. We'll finish in the next 3 days, I think. Yeah, in the next 3 days, we'll finish our reading of the Madhya Khanda of Chaitanya Bhagavat, and then we'll break for a pretty good amount of time, well, like maybe a week or so, or longer, to read about, well, it'll be my Param Gurudev's Vyas Puja, the day after, like on the 26th, so we'll read about, you know, his glories, and then for about a week, I think, we'll read all sorts of things about Śrīla Bhaktisiddhānta Sarasvati Prabhupāda on the grand occasion of his 150th Vyas Puja. I don't actually have any plans of what to read except for on the day of his appearance. I know what I'm going to read that day, but then the days before and after it. Anyways, we can discuss that later. I'm going to take off now. Thank you so much for joining, and see you all tomorrow. Hare Bol. Hare Krishna.